And welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. This is a Let's Play. Well, I kind of wish I had more stamina, didn't I? Don't I? You choose your votes. Well, you choose your options, whatever option you want at the end of this video. And majority rules. The vote is taken into effect at the beginning of the next video. I don't know. Basically, it's I don't know how I'm explaining it right. Basically, it's a interactive Let's Play, so. Yeah, place your votes at the end. So the votes at the end of the previous video. Well, let me just look. We're given an ultimatum here. So. Just reviewing. So there's two ghosts we have before us. One, the girl, says, will you help us? What does he actually want help with? To help free her. But Fildrick says, no, we cannot leave. And it says, we must leave. We are the dead, and you should be afraid of us. They're kept here by an old spell. They really don't remember much. Supposedly the girl remembers a lot more than Fildrick does. A spell of binding across the threshold to keep the spirits within. Were they present at the casting? Yes, I think so. I think I was alive when the spell was cast. I do not remember if the girl was. The little girl spins in place. Who can say? So, should we trust Fildrick or should we trust the little girl? Now, majority vote. There were only 3 votes last episode. If you guys... Hey, the more votes, the better. So, I appreciate it. I usually get more likes than votes. So, someone else is watching that doesn't vote, which is okay, you know, but the more votes, the better. So, majority rules. Last episode, the choice was to say, I do not trust you, Fildrick. And by the way, the flickering issue... I've been told has been fixed. I use shadow play and desktop mode to record these guys, so I don't know. It seems like every couple months something comes up with, I mean, they make a change with something and it affects something else, so go figure. But they mentioned there was an update and they mentioned that a flickering issue with the status indicator was fixed, so that's good. Anyway, I do not trust you, Fildrick. I care not, he shouts suddenly. I just want you gone. The young girl leads you and Fildrick towards the common room, beckoning as she goes. Okay. So let's go to the common room. And so we're trusting the little girl. At least for now. You follow her, Fildrick cursing and muttering to himself, chasing threads of memory. Once in the common room, the girl points to a musty roll of parchment stuffed underneath an old crate that you did not notice before. I'm going to pick up the parchment. You pick up the roll of parchment. It is cracked with age, but still readable. It describes a simple counterspell to the binding enchantment that has been placed on the tavern. You could perform it with ease. After Fildrick managed to write the note a few decades ago, I copied out the spell, the girl says. The old one was useless and in the wrong language. Fildrick is becoming increasingly agitated. Okay. Well, definitely leaning towards this because we're going in the path of trusting the girl. But I'm wondering, but how did you get it? A traveler left it behind, she says. Fildrick shakes his head. That does not make sense. The counterspell would have to be tailored to the enchantment. It must have been created, but I cannot remember by whom. Does it matter? The girl snaps. It will work, yes? Will you perform it for us? The girl tries to yank at your arm, but her fingers pass through your elbow. Oh yeah, the incorporeality issue. How can you be sure it will work? You demand. The girl looks at you with bug-round eyes. It has to. She murmurs. It just has to. Look over the spell. You glance down at the spell, but it is a stargraph and nothing more. There is no clue as to what stars it binds or with what affordances. It might have any effect. Well, you guys voted, so, I mean, you didn't specifically vote for this, but I'm going to follow that path. Agree to do it. You nod. I will perform the spell, you say. You examine the parchment as the girl squeals with delight. No! Fildrick's voice fills the room. His rotted corpse now is tall enough to reach the ceiling. He looms over you, poised to strike. You must not break the spell. You will not. You attempted to attack with the chain. Not to flee. Let's see this through. But I'll recite the spell. Hopefully I can attack with the chain afterwards. You recite the spell, Fildrick howling in frustration as you begin. He does nothing to stop you, however, and the little girl dances around you with delight. Yeah, if I don't have to attack him to do this, that's a plus for me. The spell finishes. You finish the spell and detect a faint shimmering near the door. Fildrick quiets, floating over to the door. Is that it? The girl asks. I expected something more dramatic. Magic is only flashy when required. Is that true? Try it out. You gesture to the threshold. Oh, boy. The little girl's grin is... so the bottom. The little girl's grin is unnaturally wide, and you see another worm curled in her teeth. Fildrick crosses his arms. Why did I create the counterspell? Was it me? He asks. The girl slides to the doorway, her form lengthening with each step. Her child's clothes begin to resemble a great cloak, her fingers morphing into claws. When she steps over the threshold, she is a head taller than Fildrick, swirled in a deep blackness. A death wraith? She's a death wraith. Thanks a lot, guys. The death wraith turned before she leaves. Oh, and it's not attacking me. Thank you, human. It has been far too long since I tore a soul from a still warm body, but your gullibility aided me, so I will reward you with your life. Fildrick chokes back a sob as the monster vanishes into the wilderness. Okay, well, I'm glad I didn't have to fight it, even with the silver chain. Okay. A merciful death wraith. Who would have thought? You return, still shaking, to the front room of the tavern. All that remains of the girl is a blonde wig, discarded by the door. Oh, God. Can I eat something? It's my last ration, though. I definitely want to take the wig. I do want to speak to Fildrick. I want to do all three. But the only problem is sometimes when you choose something, the other options go away. You pick up the wig. It is a mix of human hair and spun fiber. She could change her form at will, Fildrick mutters. I don't know why she bothered with that thing. I think she liked it. Okay, so I think we can eat something at any time, can't we? In inventory. So let's speak to Fildrick. Fildrick mopes by the threshold of the door. Haven't you done enough? He says as you approach. Why did you not warn me what she was? He didn't remember. I tried, he replied sadly, but all I can remember was how vital the spell was, and you ignored those pleas, and now she is loose after centuries of hunger. I am sorry. Apologize to her future victims, not me. What happened here? You demand. I do not understand what I have seen. She killed me. In this room, she tore my body to shreds. Perhaps she pursued me here. The spell of binding was to trap her, but I trapped her in with me, and once dead, I was also bound. Wow. Were you a sorcerer? More of a scholar of magic, but yes. I lived at the fortress in the mountains, teaching magic. I do not remember much of that life, though. All these options. Could you now leave as well? to what end? Haunt another patch of ground? No, leave me be. Perhaps with her gone I will find some measure of peace, or at least oblivion. The ghost sighs heavily. Now go, and take that thing, Fildrick says, as he nods toward a silver sword, struck up on one wall which you hadn't noticed before, in case you meet her again. A silver sword. We're definitely going to take it. I do want to talk to him some more. There were kind of few options, things to ask him, but apparently we can't. You take the sword down from the wall. Thank you. He scoffs. Hope you don't need it. You nod and leave him to his misery. Yeah, I hope he's, I hope he does find some measure of peace. I do have low stamina right now, but I... my last ration. I don't know when or how I'm going to find more rations. And again, I don't think we could withstand fighting anything like this. Let's eat something. 11 stamina, no rations. Taking the apple from your pack, you fill your empty stomach and try not to think what you will eat tomorrow. You step back over the door. Fildrick does not look up as you go. Manpang will wait no longer. I guess not. So we can't venture beyond. I do want to see if we can, like, go down this path to the ravine, if there's anything down there. It looks pretty lush. There might be some food we can gather. Maybe more apples. So if I can go down there, I will. You step away from the tavern door. The only way is back. Oh yeah, back. That back, not that back. You return down the ruined path. The sun lowers toward the horizon. It will be dark soon. Then suddenly, you feel a wave of nausea. The ground beneath you shifts. The sun slides sideways. Open my pack? Steady myself. Why would I open my pack? Am I falling? Is there a landslide? Blonde wig twirl? A long, tatty blonde wig stained with goblin blood. Don't know what I could use in my pack, but it looks like I'm either passing out the ground beneath you shifts. Is it really shifting, or am I just feeling that like it is? I know the sun doesn't slide sideways, so I'm thinking this is a feeling that I'm feeling. Cast a spell? I don't know. You open your arms to cast a spell. When you fall, the world rushes past you further than it should. You hear a woman's voice singing gently above the sound of lapping waves. What magic is this? Oh, what the hell? Where is this? Waves lull and wash towards a shore. This is the map in the first game, isn't it? This is where we came and we practiced here, tutorial. I think I ended up going up this way. Krista Tanti, I remember. It's a year ago, guys. I believe we've been doing this for a year. It's awesome, though. Yeah, the thing about the first game, it was so short because there's all these branching passages, so I mean, if you take them all, it's longer. The replay value on the first episode is really high because you can just take different passages and encounter completely different things. Not so with the other episodes. We can always rewind and go back, and it's even outside the rewind mechanic for Kari, because you have to keep going back and finding those other notes. Alright, so for parts of the spell to open the gate, I believe. Lapping water. You lie on a bed of stones, looking up at the bright sunlight. Where am I? This is not High Zaman. A feeling of dread creeps over you. What kind of trap is this? How far have you traveled? Well, I'm still laying down, so let's stand first. You pick yourself to your feet, woozy as though he'd been asleep for a long time. Greetings, murmurs a voice, warm and welcoming. We have traveled a long way together, you and I. Look for the speaker. You turn this way and that, looking for the speaker, but seeing nothing but the washing water and spray. Who are you? You call. I have many names, she replies, but none truly describe who I am. The sea washes at your boots, as though inviting you to step forwards. Pinch myself. A gentle wind tugs at your coat. As you shiver, you realize this is no dream. You are standing on the shore of the Kakabad Sea, barely a half-day's walk from Annaland. Okay. That's cute. I love the little drawings. The shore, okay. You crunch toward the shore. In the glinting water, a boat slowly rocks to and fro, and in the boat sits a woman with a loom. What should I call you? You ask. I have many names, she repeats, but one will do. So call me Libra. I am the goddess of justice. We have walked together for a long time, you and I. You kept your presence hidden? You reply. The woman is clearly a goddess, she nods. There are many times the warp serves only to support the weft, she answers. Tell me what you want with me. You reply, I bring you here to deliver a warning. Our long road together has almost reached its end. Her voice is filled with sadness. I have kept you safe many times, saved you, but I can do no more. This isn't the embodiment of the rewind feature, is it? Because we've had that the whole game. But, if we can no longer rewind... that would not be good. We have never met. You do not understand, she replies, but you will. Echoes of Kosh from Babylon 5. You do not understand, but you will. He says those exact words. Soon enough, when you enter Manpeng, you will understand. The walls around that citadel are more than those of physical stone. It is a cursed place, guarded by sigils and long knives. You mean you cannot enter? You are right, but perhaps you do not understand the cost. Annalander, for as long as you have walked, I have walked beside you. I have granted you waking dreams, dreams of your future, dreams from which you wake to walk a different way. Let her speak, Jim. You listen intently, puzzled. Waking dreams, the goddess continues, the kind that seem real until they disappear as though they had never been. She shoots the shuttle across her loom once more. Across her loom? What? Oh, she has a loom. but no more. Once inside the walls of Manpeng, your future will become precious once again. The word strikes a knell of fear in your heart. Precious? Unique. For a moment she bows her head. I can only hope you will be fortunate. Tell me what you mean. You ask, bowing your head in respect. A weave can be made, and then unmade, and made again in different fashion. The final garment does not know how many times it was stitched, so it has been with your journey. She laughs. Or perhaps you consider yourself to simply have been lucky to have survived so far. A large wave strikes the shore, and as it drains, the boat tilts and begins to drift away. The woman makes no move to stop it, merely continuing to weave.
It seems to me that she's talking about the rewind feature, right? We weave our way past the story, and then we can unmake it. And then weave our way in the story again in a different fashion.
That's what I'm taking from this, but I guess we'll find out.
Wait!
You call. How can I leave this place? But your words are lost on the water. She is gone. The thoughts of the long journey back to Manpeng begins to sink into your mind.
I don't have to walk my way all the way down, all the way through from the beginning, do I? That would be crazy.
I mean, it would give us options to take different routes that we haven't. I'll have to watch back my videos and see where exactly I haven't gone, because, sheesh. I don't remember it all. I remember going to Cristatanti. I think we went to Dumpus, and then up through here. I think these are caves with giants, possibly. So this whole section of the game, I don't believe... Oristanti, I don't think we were been to. I think here's the crossroads, and we went this way. I think. And there's Kari, city of... Well... Kari can only be reached this way. So maybe, unless we follow the river, I don't remember following a river. I don't know, guys. Maybe it's this... I remember Cantapani. I think I headed up this way. I wanted to go back to the mines, but we didn't have an option. And now I'm curious. Where exactly I went. It's only 5 videos, so I can see where... I can play back the video and see. Let's go into the cave, I guess. You step away from the water towards the mouth of a dim cave. Inside the stone drips salty tears. These tunnels must be flooded at high tide. Look around the cave. The cave walls are jagged and irregular, formed by lashing waves and the shifting rocks of 1,000 years. Here and there, crystal seams wink from deep within the frozen stone folds. Go deeper. You push deeper into the cave, climbing over fallen stones, following the line of the deepest darkness up into the towering cliffside. Somewhere overhead are the low hills around Cantapani, and a short distance from that is your home. Yeah, I heard something growl. You climb higher still, upwards into the rock, when something in the distance begins to roar and moan. You are not alone in the darkness. Maybe a light spell? Oh. You open your arms to cast a spell as a great wind begins to rush through the tunnel, gathering in strength and force as it tries to push you back. Your arms are pushed apart, and their power unbinds before it can form. And I'm falling. As you begin to fall, the stars reach down to catch you. We're going back to... We are, okay.
You were back on the cliff path. Was that real?
I have a taste in my mouth.
There is a taste of salt in your mouth, but nothing more. You shake the vision away and look around yourself once more. You must keep going. Real or not, you must keep moving.
I don't know.
Testing to make sure that mechanic is still there. Maybe once we get in the fortress, it will not be. Towards the pass. You follow the path southwards once more. The chasm yawns open on your right-hand side. Darkness closes in. You need to rest. The broken rope bridge dangles down into the ravine here. The slopes are too exposed a place to rest.
Okay, then we must forge onward. Unless we go back.
You leave the bridge behind and make your way around the edge of the chasm. Moonlight covers everything. The path splits here, snaking around the edge of a mountain while a branch works its way downwards. The ruins of a stone tower lie some way down the path. Look at the tower. Apparently we can go down there, because I see this. The tower seems to have fallen into disrepair, but its profile is familiar enough. It is the same as the towers that guarded the backlands. There are three ways to go from here.
Yeah, you guys know. I want to see if I can get down what might be in that chasm. I mean, in that tower, or if not, within the chasm. Hopefully to gather food. The ruined tower.
You pick your way down the scree slope one step at a time. You pause by the ruined tower to catch your breath.
Yeah, let's see if we can sleep here then.
You bed down amongst the fallen stones, on the outskirts of the tower. They will not give you shelter from rain or protect you from creatures, but they may offer a little comfort all the same. You do not need to eat more today. You try to lie back and forget your troubles. What is left of the night is kept busy with vivid dreams. A cold, dead hand is reaching up through the soil to grasp your ankle. Mushrooms sprout from the fingertips, and eyes on stalks grow from the mushrooms.
Ugh.
You are lying on cool, moist ground underneath a tall, swaying tree. There is a nagging pain in your leg, and you look down to see a sapling growing up through your thigh. A sapling growing. Try to move. I gain stamina, though. You try to move away, but you are attached to the ground, as though the roots of the sapling were your own tendons. And all the while you hear distant laughter from the east. Ruined Tower. During the past day, you met Libra, the goddess of justice and the long peace. The Archmage is still waiting for you.
Yeah, he can wait. Okay, I guess that was part of the dream. I guess when you wake up and you still feel like the dream is real.
You pick yourself to your feet and shake the dust from your tunic. Approach the tower. I'm more happy for our stamina now. As you move towards the tower entrance, a shadow falls across the doorway. The shape is stooped and hideous. It would seem this place is home to a troll. It has not yet noticed you.
Watch it, I guess?
You watch the creature as it paces around inside the ruined tower. It appears to be ordering things, moving stone blocks from one point to another.
Okay. Good enough. I think we're at a half-hour point. Let me know what you guys think I should do. Should I approach the troll? In which case, there's a good likelihood it will fight me, attack me. You never know, though. I don't think we've encountered trolls yet in Sorcery. So, perhaps it's a friendly troll? Well, perhaps if we fight it, we could get some loot. Some food. Perhaps trolls need to eat too, right? I guess they probably eat people, though. So we approach the troll or slip away? And hopefully I can still get down towards the chasm. If so. Because it looks like
Yeah, this continues to snake down. So let me know, cast your votes in the comments below. Should I approach a troll or slip away? Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for voting. And always, seek adventure.